Everyone up, please. Now, when I count to three, I want everyone to make a very small jump, okay? Is everyone ready? Very small jump, okay? And one, two, and three. Okay, you just created enough energy that could power a streetlight for up to 30 minutes just from that. Now please sit down, thank you very much. So in Rio, the population is just over 6 million. Now if we could utilize all the energy from everyone's footsteps just for one day, we could power more than 25,000 homes. Now, I'm an industrial design engineer, and I believe that micro changes can actually lead to macro coming from an engineer's point of view. I've been fascinated by the built environment, by our cities, and trying to look at ways that we can make them more sustainable. So I used to work at one of Europe's largest energy companies. And during that time, I was looking at how do we make cities, and especially street lighting, more sustainable. So I was looking at things like solar and things like wind and saying, can we power realistically our systems with this technology? Now, we all know the shortcomings of things like solar, as when the sun's not shining, there's no power. And with wind, when there's no wind, there's no power. So I thought, what if there was a power source that's all around us, that's literally under our feet, that's commercial, that's reliable, and where and when you need it as an off-grid power source? So in 2009, I created Pavegen. Pavegen is a flooring tile that creates around 7 watts of energy from a single footstep. So every time you stand on it, the energy is stored, and then it can be used to power applications. Now, I have a demonstration here with me today. I brought it with me all the way from London. And when you try to bring something like this on a plane, it has a battery, wires, and a timer. So you can imagine security weren't too keen to let us with it on the plane, but we managed it. So I'm just going to do a little demonstration. So we could drop the lights down, please. So as I stand on it, what we're doing is we're building up the energy just from a few of my steps is making the light line up in the center. I think if we can drop the lights a little bit, you should be able to see the central light come up. Now, this is just a small demo of me here today at TEDx, but imagine all the people walking all the time through all of our cities and how we can store that. So I'm now storing the energy from the Pavegen slab, and then I'm gonna show you it in a light and how that, just from a few of my steps alone, how that can be created. Now, this is an idea that we've been trying to take forward and learn more about how can it really exist in our cities in the future and where can it be used. So applications obviously like street lighting, powering our shops, but eventually our vision is to see this technology power our cities. Now places we can use this is obviously looking at train stations, subways, in our shopping centers, even our sports stadiums. So in the stadium in Rio, the Maracana Stadium, has nearly 100,000 people capacity. And when that's built, nearly 100 homes could be powered from the people visiting it just in for one game. Now, I'm going to talk to you about my journey with my idea and how we've delivered that. So I first started off, we were based in London. We're based in a place called Brixton in London. It's a deprived area, but a really exciting area and full of inspiration. And in Brixton, I had a laptop and a piece of paper, and that was where we started. So we started off by doing illegal installations around London and getting in lots of trouble and going into places like shopping centers, laying it down, or going into building sites and installing it so we could understand how best to do it. But we got in a lot of trouble from the police and security, so we thought we'd better find a new way. But you can see here, we wanted to know, do people want to walk on a green paving slab? Because if they didn't want to walk on it, there'd be no point having it. So we know that over 30% more people go to walk on the slab when they see it. And one of the UK's largest newspapers said, people will make a beeline for it. They'll see it, and they'll go straight for it. So we know we'll get more power from that. The slab, as you saw previously, it has a light in it. Now, that light utilizes 5% of the energy from the footstep. But the 95%, all that extra energy, is then stored. And I look at this as the gamification of energy saving. It makes it fun, but actually delivering results as well. Now, carrying on my journey now shows the first ever one I made from wood, and then also testing it in the lab. Now, we tried to do it, as I mentioned before, with illegal installations. So we thought, where else can we use this system? So I said, a school. A school is great. And the school said, yes, come in. You can try and test it out. So this is the very first time we tried it. And then we went on and we found that even with the students, they had a riot, and we had to kick them off and move them through because they were all trying to jump on the slabs. And then we were allowed to do our first short-term trial to understand how it worked. And I have a short video to show. So you can see that it was engaging, they really enjoyed it. And then we had the idea, we'd shown it, and suddenly a newspaper in the UK wrote about us. And then a few others decided to write about us, and then everyone started to write about us. And we were going, oh no, we have the idea, we need to go take it forward. And how do you take that idea forward? And after everyone wrote about us, we even had Will I Am from the Black Eyed Peas dancing on it. The Prime Minister of the United Kingdom wanted it to install it inside the government offices. So we thought, wow, we better get this thing ready for them. So we started our journey. This is my favorite machine. This is my rain machine that allows us to test how well the product can withstand the water. Because actually, it's one of the harshest environments known to man on the ground. People walk on you every day. Water comes down, it floods. Water comes up from the bottom. People are sick on you. People are vandalizing it. So it has to be very, very durable. And this is another one of the tests we had to do. I needed to find a 300 kilogram woman. Unfortunately, I couldn't find one, and I needed them to walk in high-heeled shoes, in stiletto heels. So we found a machine that would do it for us, and this shows how we managed to get the testing done. And now, this is another one of my favorite machines. This is how we tested 1 million footsteps on a Pavegen slab. You can see here, it took over 2 weeks to do 1 million steps, and that's a step every second. And shortly, you can see on the video that I think I've stuck a one in the corner because we got to 1 million, and that was, we ran out of space on the counters. But if you imagine, in our cities, we need 20 million, 50 million steps. So we've had to go through the process of over a year of continuous testing to get the product to work in that way. At the end of our testing, we, in 2010, were asked to install in a school. And this was a permanent installation. I now have 1,100 students who devote their lives to destroying Pavegen. Every single day, they jump and run up and down on the slabs, and it powers the lights in the corridor as they walk through. We've learned a lot from this, and some of the findings we've found is shown above. So you can see the beginning of the day, and then at the end of the day. Now, the students come in at 9, you can see the energy goes up, and then they go to lessons, and then it goes through the day, and at lunchtime they eat their food, and they get all the energy from their food, and we get nearly 3,000 footsteps during a 15-minute period from the students. And then in the afternoon, it drops off, and then they go home. And then the cleaners come out, and then they jump on them themselves afterwards. Now, I wanted to explore other ways that we could use it, all about taking the idea from a micro solution through to something big. So I love festivals, and I wanted to see how can we utilize it at a festival or a carnival. So with all the people moving, how could you use that as a power source? Now, I know that the average person at a festival uses 1.5 liters of diesel each day they're there. Now, imagine 70,000 people at a festival for 5 days, and how much diesel that is using. And we need to reduce our reliance on fossil fuels. So I came up with an idea, and this is what we did. So at this festival alone, we charged more than 1,000 mobile phones just in 3 days. But then we hope to go back, and my vision is the whole festival could be powered from all the people walking, running, and dancing in them themselves. Now the next step we had to make was to understand how does this technology work outdoors in very harsh environments. So I took it to Bulgaria and did an installation there, and this is what happened. So what you just saw there was the Bulgarian energy minister doing hopscotch down on our slabs in the center of Sofia. And the photo up on screen now is the scariest photo I've ever seen. It's Pavegen at minus 12 degrees under 1 inch of snow. Now, at that stage, I didn't know whether it would work. And you can see it was still lighting up, and it still worked. So the next part is transport. We've looked at how to use it in small areas in cities, but on a much bigger, on a macro scale. So I believe that on a large sites with lots of people moving through in our cities could actually power the whole areas themselves, all the lighting. Now, the London Olympics is just upon us now, and we will see the first installation of Pavegen in a transportation hub. Now, this may not look like much, but this is a tube station in London, right where the Olympic Games is. Now, this will be possibly one of the highest footfalls in the world next month with the London Olympics. So we're expecting, with an installation of our technology, to power more than half the lights in that train station alone. Now, because it's TED today, I wanted to do a demonstration that we hadn't done before that's a way of connecting a technology, a form of renewable energy, but with communication. So I'm going to play a short video that we filmed in our lab just 3 days ago, and then we'll go through and do a live demo. Okay, here we have the Pavegen Twitter test. Okay, come through here. We're in the Pavegen lab right now. Gilmore here has built a circuit that's going to convert the energy from a Pavegen into a signal that's going to send a live tweet from Hussein jumping on a slab. So Hussein, you ready?
Yeah.
Ready to go?
Sure.
Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Okay, let's see if it works. Okay, let's come through. Okay, so we're all hooked up here. We've got Jeff McDaddy ready. Tweet's just come in. Let's have a look at it. Jeff McDaddy says, "What up, Ted? Sent from a very cold and grey London from a Pavegen." Good work, guys. Great stuff. We got it. Yeah, worked well. Yeah, we sent the tweet. Yeah. So, thanks. We're going to try and recreate that here today. So, I have my rubber ducky, and he's going to send us some tweets. So the rubber ducky is now going to be connected into Pavegen. And so when I stand on it, the rubber ducky is going to be sending out the messages through. And you can see on a laptop here, where we're wirelessly picking it up at the back of the room. Now, my assistant here has got a, we've got a live hookup. Hopefully we can get it on the screen. And if everyone can have a look at, we've got the hashtag and the Twitter at sign there. We're going to see if we can pick it up on the screen. Now, you guys here today possibly have more technology in front of you than most small companies. I can see with all the iPads around. So we might be seeing a small delay on the tweet coming in. But from that footstep, it will be coming through. So we're going to get a shout out when it comes in live from that. I think we're hooked up on the 3G. But we've all got big hopes for Rio over the next few weeks with this summit. There's vital things that the global leaders need to do, and things like encouraging new forms of technologies that are going to make up the future breakdown of how we see our energy being supplied from need to be addressed. And my vision is that Pavegen can play a key component in the makeup with technologies like solar, like wind, but also technologies that haven't even been invented yet, new ones that come through. Things like the smart grid, that needs infrastructure, but it needs big government changes and decisions, but very long-term ones that need to happen. So the eyes of the world are on Rio now, and we really hope that we can make a difference. I'm just gonna check in. Have we got a tweet come through yet, live? These things never work live with all the things going on. Okay, so how are we doing? Any second now it might come in? Yeah, we got them. Here we go. Showing how human power can really change the world with TED at TEDx Rio. So thanks very much, everyone, for getting that through. It worked. Yeah. There we go. Very relieved that technology worked live on stage. So my vision is that when all of you walk to work in the morning over the next year or two, that every step and every street you make will be on your own Pavegen slab. Thank you very much.